Hi students, welcome back to our class. This is Swarupa ma'am. Today we have started Russian socialistic revolution. Okay, so Russian socialistic revolution, it has occurred from 1917 to 1922. So what happened? I said you the first Russian revolution of 1917, the 10,000 women went there, okay, and opposed, and even the soldiers also supported the women's itself. Okay, I said you in the earlier class. Right now we will continue the same class about the Russian socialist revolution. Okay, see here ma, Russian socialist revolution, a bigger revolution took place later in October 1917. See here, October 1917, March revolution has occurred. Later, after this also, the revolution has occurred, another revolution. They did not stop until the Second World War. They did not stop any revolution there. Okay, so what happened in the bigger revolution in which has occurred in October 1917? What has happened now we will know. It was not a spontaneous, it's a liberals and aristocrats ruled Russia after the abdications of the Tsars. Okay, so aristocrats, see here, aristocracy, the highest class of certain society typically comprising people of nobles. See here, aristocracy means they just comprise the people, of lower categories and little bit poor people. The rich people comprise there, that is called as aristocracy. Birth holdings and hereditary titles and offices, hereditary titles, rajala kalam nundi meme rajulam annattu they behave, okay na. So dorallaga, so many these all people, like feudal lords, this all comes under aristocracy itself, okay na. So aristocracy, here aristocracy ruled Russia, liberals and aristocrats, after this war these people aristocrats and aristocracy people ruled the Russia after the abdications of the Tsars. They decided to continue the war to save the honors of Russia, okay na. So Russia wanted to continue the war there, okay na. The common people were tired of military actions and economic shortages. The common people who were participating frequently in the war since 1914 onwards, nearly, see here, for corona, for 5-6 months only, so many people have lost their jobs. They couldn't tolerate, and many people are unable to tolerate the less economic conditions and loss of jobs, okay. But here, how many years these people are tolerating, common people are tolerating the revolutions since 1660s onwards, French Revolution, from that time onwards, Battle of Plassey, from that time onwards these people go on suffering. And this First World War also, 1914 onwards, now still they are suffering. How could they tolerate for how many days? Okay, that is also much important. They couldn't tolerate this all economic shortage, did not wanted the war. Okay, so actually Russian people, again they wanted to do the war, but due to less shortage of economy, they didn't wanted to go for war. Common people didn't wanted to go for war. They began organizing themselves in councils which were called Soviets. Okay, so common people, they didn't wanted to move into the war. They has formed a councils, those called as Soviets. Okay, Soviets, an elected local. What is meant by Soviets? These are the elected local, district, as well as a national councils in the form of Soviet Union. Okay, councils, I said councils in the form of councils. Now normal people has formed into into the councils, nothing but these into the district level, national level, as well as in the rural level, in the local elected body started developing, okay na. So unions are present. See here, my unions are present for any employment. See here, if you go for the factories, there is a union, leader compulsory, there will be a union. If you go for the RTC, there will be a union. here also normal people only always combines to be the union, okay na? So here also normal people, common people wanted to form a union, council of union, in the that we will call it as Soviets, okay na? Those were elected only, again, okay, elected bodies, okay. Next, these Soviets of soldiers, in mainly of soldiers, Soviets of soldiers, industrial workers and peoples in rural areas were united by the group of these Soviets, who were the councils. These people mainly from the industrial places as well as from the rural areas, they united to form a group of Russian Communist Party, okay. These wanted to unite, they united to form a Russian Communist Party group of party called as Bolsheviks, okay na? Bolsheviks. They has formed, see here, groups of Russian Communist Party. These people, Soviets, were united by the group of Russian Communist Party called Bolsheviks. Okay na? Bolsheviks. These groups represented the common people power. So common people power was represented by these groups. Okay? These groups, see here, what happened after this, mainly Vladimir Lenin, another one, Vladimir Lenin, we know Lenin, Stalin, these were the persons, legendary persons who ruled many years, okay. So Lenin, Vladimir Lenin, from 1870, his life period was 1870 to 1924, was a leader of Bolsheviks. Okay, so this was occurring in 1917. This was occurred in the 1917. He was the leader. This is the union. This is the group. They formed just a group there. Okay, so what happened? Vladimir Lenin in 18. What he did? He was the leader of Bolsheviks. Bolsheviks was able to get the support of Soviets. So he was the leader of Bolsheviks. Okay na? So Bolsheviks got the support of Soviets. Generally these Council of Soviets only was Council of Soviets as well as the groups of Communist parties of Russia has formed a party called Bolsheviks. Okay, so here this party got supported by Soviets, by the Soviets, because of the demand for the immediate and unconditional peace, mainly for the demand for the immediate and unconditional peace, mainly what is the demand, peace only they want. Even the women's demand was also peace itself, okay. So they also demanded that all the land should be nationalized. They also demanded the land should be nationalized, redistributed to the peasants. Bolsheviks wanted control over the prices of nationalisms of the factories and banks. So they wanted to distribute all the land. They wanted to get their nationalism back. Means only they don't want to be under the control of any other leaders. Okay, any other leaders or any other countries suppressing this country. Okay, so that's why they made this party, mainly for their peace. Okay, na? Peace. And Bolsheviks wanted control over the prices. The Soviets under the Bolshevik leadership seized power from the provinces. So who were the Soviets present? Under the leadership of Bolsheviks, they have seized the provincial government in powers of provincial government, okay na? Provincial government in November 1917, between October and November 1917, they immediately took steps in the ends of the war and redistributed the land. So what did these Bolshevik people with the help of Soviets, they have done? they have completely redistributed whoever the feudal lords were there. They have taken all the land from the peasants, okay, and suppressing them. Okay, they have given very little amount of money for their culture, cultivation of the land. So these lands was returned to the peasants, and they have got their nationalism back again. Okay, so here Russia could not return to the complete peace. Here Bolsheviks as well as Soviets wanted to bring the peace, and they wanted to get their own rights, own just like constitution type. Okay, na? But what this Russia, they did, they couldn't accept their defeat always. Okay, so what they have did, they immediately took steps ends of the war and distributed. Russia could not return to the complete peace because the civil war was started. So Russia could not return to the complete peace. See, Russian people, these are all Bolsheviks and Soviets, these all are the Russian people itself. They wanted to be the peace, wanted to be in peace. But what happened? Immediately the civil war started. This war led by the white armies of Russian monarchists and anti-communist soldiers. So here the wars led by the white armies means maybe Europeans, white armies of Russian monarchists and anti-communist soldiers with the help from the Britain, France, USA. See here, they started the civil war. So who took, even all the people are not good, all the people are not bad also. So what is happening, the people in the Russia itself, few are monarchists, few are anti against the Soviets as well as the Bolsheviks. Okay, what happened, they has gone and combined, took the help of Britain, France, USA, Japan. These are always interrupting all the other countries. Okay, so they have gone and they have took the help. They were all defeated in 1920. Okay, what happened, Russian monarchists and anti-communist soldiers with the help from the Britain, they have took the help of Britain, France, Russian, other anti-monarchists, what happened, they has combined with these countries. Again in the civil war also, they have got defeated. Okay, so the Bolsheviks also announced the end of Russian Empire. So how much they could tolerate, they couldn't tolerate. At last these Bolsheviks, they has kept an end for the Russian Empire. Okay, Russian Empire, and permitted the various nations under it to become independent. So whatever the nations present under this, Russia is one of biggest one. So they have, whatever they wanted to make it independent, they had made the independent nations. And however, gradually most of the nations that came under the empire of the Tsars, so few nations went under the empireism of Tsars and agreed to join the USSR. Okay, na? So USSR, they have joined in the USSR. See here, Union of Soviets Socialist Republics. Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. Republics means constitution formation, mostly the democracy. Okay, they got their own democratic countries, they has lead their independence. Okay, up mostly in 1947 we got, in the same way one by one each and every country started getting their independent by many wars itself. Okay, so here the Tsars agreed to join the USSR. Okay, na? Union of Soviet Socialist Republic, which got set up by the Soviet government of Russia in 1922. Okay, na? So 1922 up to the 1922 Russian socialistic revolution has ended by the formation of this one. Okay, who has formed this one? Russian government itself has formed the USSR. R means not Russia, ma, it is Republic. Okay, so this started a great experiment in building a country with exploiters like feudal lords. So mainly USSR formation has led to the exploitation, removal of the feudal lords, kings of capitalists. USSR tried to build a society that was industrialized and modern. So wanted, what USSR thing, they wanted to build a society with the build a society mainly with industrialized, mostly industrialized and modern. See here, how much our country gets industrialized, modern, that much we can tell that has a, economically they give lot of support, employment to many people and economic growth. It leads to the economic growth. So this, by this we can tell that the, though the country is very small, if they are industrially developed, if they are giving, if they are economically well developed, very small countries also we can call it as a developed country itself. Okay, so here they did not, yet they did not inequality and inequality or exclusions of people on the basis of birth. So yet they did not have any inequalities. These USSR people, they started developing industrially as well as economically. They didn't show any inequalities in genders. Yes, this is female, this is male. We will give any specification for specially for the male. In that way, they did not show in that days itself. Basis of birth and language. See here, birthplace here, how we can tell the inequality in birthplace? See here, birthplace, we comes under Telangana locality, Nizamabad district, local candidates. If you go for the other district, any job, we comes under non-local category. Means birthplace, it is a little bit inequality can be shown. Non-locals, if we try for the other, some other ex-state, we becomes a non-local again there. See here, basis of birth. This basis of birth, such type of gender differences, basis of birth and languages, it was not shown in those days. Okay, na? So this is about the Russian socialistic revolution. How Russian socialistic revolution has ended? By the formation of the USSR, after the civil war. Okay, na? After the civil war. This is about the Russian socialistic revolution. Okay, hope you understood. We'll continue the class Rise of Stalin next.